In this video, I've got Vince Venturella in the studio, and we're going to talk about balancing paint hobby and playing. So, number one, thanks for coming.
Yeah, happy to be here.
It's great. I was cool that we were able to kind of pull this together.
Yes.
We were on a stream recently on Sam's channel.
That's right.
And so that was a lot of fun. And so the idea was basically, I wanted to see if you could come up here and we could talk a little bit about just different things. I've been doing different talks with Sam and a couple other people and stuff. And I think that the one thing I want to talk to you about was there are a lot of painters out there and there are a lot of players out there, but you go pretty heavy into both.
I try.
And you've been doing that for how long, roughly?
Pretty heavy into both for about the last 5 years, 6 years, something like that.
Did you start more in gaming or more in painting? And then, or
definitely started as a player.
Yeah.
And hate painted.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? And then eventually decided I wanted to be better.
Yeah.
Paint better.
Sure.
We all have that moment where we want to, where we say, really?
Yeah.
This is what I'm still generating. This is how it's still coming out.
Yeah, yeah.
I can do better than this.
Right.
So then that happened.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. And then what did you, so you said that was maybe roughly 5 years ago?
Yeah.
So it was pretty easy to start taking a look at the internet and YouTube and all that
yes.
jazz and everything like that. And then when did you decide you wanted to start making your own content?
Shortly after that.
Yeah, yeah.
But it didn't start out really as hobby content. I'd already been painting for a long time, started working on improvements, mm-hmm. you know, and got to a point where I thought, oh, I've figured out a lot of cool things. I want to start sharing that with people. I like teaching people. I think it's fun. So it's maybe a year later.
Okay, that's cool. And your channel, people should just look for Vince Venturella in the YouTubes there. You've got a very long running sort of thing called hobby cheating.
Yes.
Which I really enjoy checking out a lot of things because you kind of deep dive into very specific things, and the concept of hobby cheating is really more about trying to find ways to do things quickly.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, the concept behind it originally was, I feel like there's a lot of things that people go to too much effort on.
Mm-hmm.
What I mean by that is just the only resource in your life you will never get back is time.
Right.
Everything else comes back, right? So I thought, well, there's a lot of shortcuts and easier ways to do things, and that's what I really want to focus on.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually, that's grown. Some of my videos, because I really try to show people the detail of the stuff, are an hour-long tutorial on how to paint something. I'm not cutting anything out a lot of times. But yeah, a lot of it is, look, you can achieve this higher quality thing quicker.
Mm-hmm.
That's the goal.
I know I've done it where I've sat down and been doing projects where I've got 6 layers of wash in this one area that I fade. And then I do another model and that's in that same unit. And then there's just this voice in the back of my head that just says, but what if you only did 3? Would you notice? And then you do it, and then you don't notice the difference.
Right.
And that's kind of, now, again, you are, well, here's the question, I guess. When you're talking about hobby cheating, you are not talking about this is a easier way to get into a crystal brush or a golden demon or anything like that. This is more for getting models on tables.
Yeah, I think in that concept of it, that's right.
Yeah.
But that being said, I think there are still, it's still absolutely applies to competition stuff too, or display, or the best unit in your army, your
sure.
big characters, whatever it is. You know, you can sit there with here's a really easy example.
Mm-hmm.
You can sit there with a brush and you can very carefully glaze to smooth a blend, and that might take a half hour or an hour depending on the size of the blend you're trying to work.
Right.
Or I can go do it with an airbrush in 30 seconds.
Right, exactly.
That's a cheat, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And by the way, I never use cheating in any kind of derogatory fashion. It's meant for like exactly what it is. It's a shortcut.
The term, I guess, is maybe a bit provocative as a title for people to come into the channel.
I am trying to get people to click a thing.
Exactly, yeah. No, absolutely. But I think it totally makes sense because like I like to talk a lot about, and I've been doing this myself a lot lately, I'm not interested as much I'm not a display painter at all. So for me, it's more of a, how can I get these things on the table quickly?
Right.
You know, like the thing you said, but like you can blend it for a really long time or you could use 30 seconds of an airbrush. I'm a big fan of that, you know, because if you can find the way to spend a little bit of money on an airbrush maybe, or even just like do some rattle can tricks, whatever, to make it look like you blended that cape from like white to black, and then
right.
maybe you threw like a quick like wash or like glaze over it, more likely a glaze, and now it looks like you blended it from like red to like almost like maroon. Those are all ways that you can just get onto painting more stuff.
Yeah, Exactly. And so the question becomes then, you know, how do you, a lot of times you see people focus, they say, well, I'm really all about the hobby, or I only play, or stuff like that. And that's fine. If you know yourself and you know where you are on your journey, you're comfortable with it, cool. Live your best life.
Absolutely.
I have no problem with that. But I think there are people who want to be better at both and feel like those two things conflict. I don't think they do. I think you just have to make choices.
Yeah.
You have to make decisions like, I'm going to only play, collect and paint one army in a year.
Right.
And I will focus on that force, both painting and playing, so that I actually understand it.
Right.
Right. The butterfly syndrome will hurt you in painting and it will hurt you in playing.
Yeah. Yeah. And, but I like to hop around a lot myself.
Sure.
But then I'm also not trying to paint to a crazy high level, and I'm also not trying to win any kind of tournaments.
Sure.
Speaking of which, so this is something I know very little about, but like, how did you go from being a beginning player to someone who does pretty well at tournaments and things like that? I'm assuming it's something called practice. You know what I mean? People want to know if there's a hobby cheat for that. Well, it wouldn't be a hobby cheat. It would be you don't want to say gamer cheats, because that's a whole different
whole
thing.
Different
also, yeah,
thing,
yeah, no, you don't want that. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
I think it is. So it, the same principle applies. You're right. It is practice.
Mm-hmm.
But as well, it's sort of understanding the fundamentals. It's actually the same lessons apply to both.
Mm-hmm.
So you can cheat when you hobby if you understand the fundamentals, right? Because when you get down and understand, all right, what I'm trying to do to get something to look good is have a high contrast. That's what we're aiming at.
Okay, sure.
Cool. What's the easiest way I can get there, right? I use the airbrush for this. You mentioned the rattle can priming trick,
sure.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's just a trick to get at the highest contrast possible as fast as possible.
Exactly.
And that's because you want the fundamentals. Playing is the same thing. Mm-hmm. Once you understand the core fundamentals, this is the way the game operates, this is the general things you're going to do. You need some unit that's going to be quite aggressive, you need some unit that's going to be quite defensive, you need a couple units to stand in the way, whatever it happens to be. Applies to any game.
Sure.
Right? No matter what game you're playing, they all have some kind of fundamental strategies that generally you're going to use to get to victory.
Right.
And if you understand those fundamentals, then one, you can build a better list, which means two, you can paint less stuff if you're just trying to build toward that list. You can get to the good list faster.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not, maybe painting other things you don't necessarily need to use. And then three, you can practice more with that good list that you've now taken more time to paint, and everything can feed each other.
Right. I mean, I guess the question partially is that, like, I mean, we talked about practice for a second there, but, if you practice a whole bunch, you are just maybe through trial and error finding what works.
Sure.
Is there a way, how did you figure out what works quicker, or is there a way? I'm asking for a friend, as it turns out. I'm just, because that's, but you see what I'm saying?
Like, I do.
Do you have to read Sun Tzu? I mean, what's exactly, is there ways to, is it watching battle reports?
It's definitely watching battle reports.
Okay.
And listening to that kind of content. I mean, the YouTube and the online, the internet age, but especially YouTube, has led to this completely unprecedented explosion in hobby quality.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Everybody was able to learn from everybody else, exchange ideas very quickly.
Yep.
And all of a sudden we see all sorts of painters using these advanced techniques and trying things and getting feedback. Okay. It's the exact same thing for playing.
Right.
Right, because you can watch really good players, you can watch streams of top tables, you can see what are the choices those people are making. It's the same way. When you're watching a painter, why did he choose to use that color? He chose to use, a bright yellow instead of a white so that there's more richness, there's more, the color's more luminous, right?
Sure.
Okay, why did this person choose to move this unit like this? So they had something in the way and they were planning ahead for this turn.
Right, right, yeah.
It's the same thoughts.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I think it's interesting to see how the different there are two halves of the overall hobby. A lot of times when I say hobby, I mean the painting part, but the wargaming overall hobby.
Mm-hmm.
There is a lot of, as it turns out, and I bet you it's in most things, that practice is actually pretty important. I think that if you want to get into music, practice is super important. You want to be a very good driver, race car driver. It's all practice. And I think that a lot of times, specifically on YouTube, people are looking for the ways like, well, what's the magic bullet? How do I beat that?
Right.
And hobby cheats, like, you know, like your stuff, and paying a lot of attention to watching a lot of games that are out there, those both help, but they don't completely do the job.
No, it's shortcuts. It's learning tools. Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it still helps you then deliberate practice.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I would say.
Yeah.
The key isn't just to do it in a non-introspective way. The more you are deliberate about what you're trying, whether it's in your hobby or on the table or in any element of it. You know, the beautiful thing about wargaming is that it is so multifaceted, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not just even the painting and the playing. We could talk about the craft side of it and terrain making.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
All of this kind of stuff. And there's just so much to learn and explore. And you're going to get better at any of that when you sort of, one, look around the world and say, okay, what all's out there?
Yeah.
You know, what and who can I learn from? And then two, you then deliberately practice that stuff.
Right, exactly.
You deliberately take the same list. You deliberately play against tough armies or mm-hmm. you play unusual scenarios or whatever your choice is.
Absolutely, yeah. So practice is still, unfortunately, super important. We do, and you're totally right, we do live in a time where, like back in the day, if you wanted to learn about some special technique, you might talk to like an old guy at the back of the game shop,
right,
who was like, well, you know what you do is you need to use that floor polish stuff, and that's
yes.
the best, you know, that's the, and now you just go look online and you can find it, and
right.
so the internet is that old guy, except that he's everywhere. I don't know that actual analogy works out, but it's important for people to understand that to not just learn, but to actually practice is the way that you actually get better. I did a video about that a long time ago about saying just watching a bunch of YouTube videos is not actually going to make you better. Watching those and then doing.
Yes, you got to do the do part.
Right, yeah.
Also, I do like the internet as pictured as a giant old man who's everywhere. I think that's fun.
Actually, we'd spread that around. I don't have a problem.
100%.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Well, I just want to, again, thank you for coming by, and I hope that I hope that these things help people to some degree, you know, like talking about different stuff. And in this situation, I think it was interesting to talk to someone who's doing both sides of the gaming. And eventually, like, I want to talk to someone who's just like total tournament and see how that works, because I don't really, that's not my area.
It'll be a very Abbott and Costello type of situation when you have them on our
right. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah. And for our younger listeners, use the internet. Use that old man and look up Abbott and Costello.
Thank you very much for having
me, sir.
Absolute pleasure.
Absolutely.